are great. You are great. You are great. Jesus, you are great. You are great.
You are great.
You are great. You are great. Everything written.
Everything written about you is great.
Come on, sing. Demons tremble. Demons tremble at your presence. What a mighty God we serve.
What a mighty God we serve.
Sing glory, glory, hallelujah.
Glory, glory, hallelujah.
And everything,
everything written about you is great.
Say demons tremble at,
'cause demons tremble at your presence.
What a mighty God we serve.
What a mighty God we serve.
Sing glory, glory.
Glory, glory, hallelujah.
Everything written about you.
Everything written about you
is great. Say you are great.
You are great.
Yes, you are, you are.
Is great.
You are great. You are great.
You are great.
You are great. You are great.
You are great.
You are great.
You are great.
You are great. You are great. Everything written.
Everything written about you
is great. 'Cause you are God alone, from before time began. You are on your throne, and you are God.
You are God alone.
And right now, in the good times and bad, you are on
your throne.
You are God.
And you are not a God dependent. Awesome in all your ways, and my
nobody greater, nobody greater,
nobody greater,
nobody greater than you.
Sing, nobody greater, nobody greater,
nobody greater,
nobody greater,
nobody greater,
nobody greater than you.
Come on, we gotta declare on this morning.
Nobody greater,
nobody greater,
nobody greater,
nobody greater,
nobody greater than you.
Sing, nobody, nobody greater,
nobody greater,
nobody greater,
nobody greater than you.
There's nobody greater. There's nobody greater. Cause it's your breath in our lungs, so we pour out a praise,
pour out a praise.
It's your breath in our lungs, so we pour out a praise
to you only.
It's your breath in our lungs, so we pour out a praise,
we pour out a praise.
It's your breath in our lungs, so we pour out a praise to you only. For great are you, Lord. I'm gonna sing you. You give life, you are love, you bring light to the darkness,
you restore,
you restore,
you restore.
Come on, every heart,
every heart that is broken.
Come on, say you give life, you give life,
you give life. You bring light to the darkness. You give hope.
You restore, every heart.
Every heart that is broken.
Oh, great are you, Lord. Great are you, Lord. Come on, sing it to your breath.
It's your breath
And all the earth will shout your praise.
Our hearts will cry, these horns will say,
for great
are you, Lord.
And all the earth will shout your praise. Our hearts will great, because greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. That's why he is great, and he will always be great. He's a God that will never leave you, he will never forsake you. That's the God we serve. We thank him for his goodness. As we take up this morning tithes and offering, we're just going to welcome our Bishop Sonny Williams just to make a declaration over our offering.
Amen. So let me invite you at this time to brought your gifts to the Lord, to take them out wherever you have them. And we say that offering time is a time to express love towards God and to exercise your faith in God. I remember the story in the book of John of the feeding of the 5,000. Note what made the difference When the 5 loaves and the 2 small fish were lifted up from the domain of the natural into the realm of the supernatural. When 5 ordinary loaves and 2 small fish switch management, switch from the natural laws to the laws of the kingdom, they fed 5,000 and 12 baskets were left. And I do the same this morning with your gift. As we lift them before God, Lord, we pray that you would exercise now authority over those gifts. For those gifts are no more under natural laws. They are under the kingdom laws. That God, you will multiply supernaturally. We release upon these gifts your blessings now as we consecrate them to you, O God. And we thank you, Father, for the miracles that would be released as our hands release these into your hands. And we give you thanks now, God, for the miracles that we will all receive. In Jesus' name, amen. As we continue to worship, we will now give.
If you are standing on the solid rock, and you know the power that you have, Satan, you can prevail. Satan, you bound to fail. If you are standing
on the solid rock, and you know the power that you have, Satan, you can prevail.
Can't prevail.
Nuntal. Praise the Lord. Just remain standing as we call Brother Richard Bailey to come and do our intercessory prayer.
Good morning, church. Oh, come let us praise the Lord, for he is good. He said, blessed is the man that walketh not in the counsel, but in the presence of the Lord. Father, behold, I stand before your door and knock this morning, O God. As I come before you, O God, I bring, O God, our people before you this morning, O God. Our nation, O God, this morning. Father, you say, O God, righteousness is righteousness sustain a nation, but sin is the reproach, O God, on each and every one this morning. Father and God, I bring St. Vincent and the Grenadines before you this morning, O God. Father and God, as I bring St. Vincent and the Grenadines before you, O God, from the north to the south, from the south to the east, and from the east to the west this morning, O God. Father, my heart bleed out for this country of St. Vincent and the Grenadines this morning, O God. Father, and you say in your words, O God, that you will never leave us nor forsake us, O God. So, Father and God, we need you now more than ever in this country, O God. Father and God, you know our young people, O God, these days, O God. From the oldest to the youngest, O God, when you walk the street, O God, of St. Vincent and the Grenadines, O God, you know, O God, the heart this morning, O God. My heart are bleeding for the young people, O God. When you see them by the roadside, O God, they're drinking, smoking, O God, and gambling, doing all kind of things there, God. Father and God, I pray, O God, that you may touch them, O God. Touch them, O God, and let them come to know you, O God, before it's too late, dear God. Father and God, let them realize, oh God, there is room at the cross of them, oh God. So Father and God, I pray, oh God, this morning, once more, oh God, for St. Vincent, oh God. Father, oh God, we have 56 more days left in this year, oh God. And Father, oh God, as I read my book on my phone last night, oh God, we have 46 murder, oh God. So far they say, oh God. Father God, let it not be no more, oh God. Father and God, let these young men put down their guns, oh God, and come and serve you, oh God. There is only you, oh God, can make a way for each and every one, oh God. So Father and God, touch them, oh God, this morning. Touch your souls, this touch soul this morning. Let your people repent, oh God. Father, let the young men, oh God, come before you, oh God. Father, there are some young men out there, oh God, we just cannot reach, oh God. They are so hard-hearted, oh God. Father, they don't believe in you, oh God, but one day, oh God, they will come to their senses, oh God, before it's too late. So, Father and God, I pray, oh God, let your Holy Spirit move within our people, oh God. Father, let them touch them, oh God. Let them come before you, oh God. There is still room for one. Though many are there before, oh God, there is still room for one. So, Father and God, I pray, oh God, once more for our people, especially our young men. Oh God, we're losing them, oh God. We're losing them slowly, oh God. Father and God, let them come before your throne and seek your grace, oh God, before it's too late. So, Father and God, just have your divine will, oh God, in each and every one this morning, oh God. Father, bless our government, oh God. From the Governor General right down, oh God, to each and every one there, God. Father, if we have a righteous nation, oh God, everyone will be right there, Father, before you. So, Father and God, just have your way. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Praise the Lord. You may have a seat for a moment. And we're going to have a special song from our dear sister, Janice Cumberbatch. Give her a hand as she comes.
Good morning, church. In 2 Corinthians 12 and verse 9, it says, but he said to me, my grace is sufficient for you, for my power is made perfect in weakness. Therefore, I will boast all the more gladly of my weaknesses, so that the power of Christ may rest upon me. And this morning, I want to say that God's grace still amazes me. enduring friend. Your tender mercy is like a river with no end. It overwhelms me. Covers my sin. Each time I come into your presence, I stand in wonder once again. Your grace still amazes me. Your love is still a mystery. Each day I fall on my knees. Your grace still amazes me.
Scripture reading, We're going to call on Sister Shanice John to do a scripture reading. It will be taken from Matthew chapter 7, from 7 to 11.
Good morning, church. This morning's scripture reading will be taken from Matthew chapter 7, 7 to 11. Here beginneth, "Ask, and it shall be given unto you. Seek, and ye shall find. Knock, and it shall be opened unto you. For everyone that asketh, receiveth, and he that seeketh, findeth, and to him that knocketh, it shall be opened. For what man is there of you, whom if his son asks bread, will he give him stone? Or if he ask him a fish, will he give him a serpent? If ye then, being evil, know good gifts unto your children, how much more shall your Father, which is in heaven, give good things to them that ask him? Therefore, all things whatsoever ye do, that men should do to you, do ye even so to them, for this is the law of the prophets." Here ends the scripture reading.
Amen. And this morning, we just want to welcome our bishop as he comes to bless our hearts with the word.
Amen. Good morning. Good morning, and how are you doing? All right, so great seeing you. Great seeing you. Let's pray. Our Father, we thank you. You are such a lovely, wonderful Savior. Lord, when we think of your grace, grace upon grace, that we didn't deserve it. We just can't earn it. But you continue to just shower your blessings upon us. We thank you, Father, for life, for this beautiful gift. We ask now, Holy Spirit, speak to us. We cannot understand your word except your spirit reveals it to us. And we trust you today, God, for understanding. So thank you for the spirit of understanding and revelation. Let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in your sight, O God, my strength and my redeemer. In Jesus' name, amen. On Saturday, this Saturday, the funeral service of the late Elvis, what's his surname? Bulls, will be held here at Glad Tidings. Is there a time? At 1 o'clock. And we want to express our deepest condolences to his relatives on his passing. So let me take you back to the reading. It's from the book of Matthew, chapter 7, and we are looking from verse 7 to 11. And we will look at a theme, ask, A-S-K. Ask, seek, knock. That's ask. Thank you. very simple on the surface passage. Three verbs: ask, seek, and knock. And are very familiar. But this is the New Living Translation version of it. It says, keep on asking, and you will receive what you ask for. Keep on seeking, and you will find. Keep on knocking, and the door will be opened to you. For everyone who asks, receives. Everyone who seeks, finds. And to everyone who knocks, the door will be opened. You parents, if your children ask for a loaf of bread, do you give them a stone instead? Or if they ask for a fish, do you give them a snake? Of course not. So if you sinful people know how to give good gifts to your children, how much more will your heavenly Father give good gifts to those who ask? I love the translation of the Message. It says, don't bargain with God. Be direct. Ask for what you need. This isn't a cat and mouse hide and seek game you are in. If your child asks for bread, do you trick them with sawdust? If he asks for a fish, do you scare him with a live snake on his plate? As bad as you are, you won't think of such a thing. You're at least decent to your own children. So don't you think the God who conceived you in love will do even better? Of course. Of course, God will. You see, the translations or the versions of the Bible that paid attention to the Greek they all put it, keep on asking, keep on seeking, keep on knocking. So Jesus is talking about persistent prayer. And we will, over some Sundays, we will talk a little about persistent prayer. And this being the first one of them. Prayer is not for quitters. Do you believe that? Prayer is not for quitters. Prayer does not work like a vending machine. You put in a prayer and you take an answer. God is not like the Coke machine, where you put in a dollar, the dollar is ask, seek, and knock, and magically you get an answer. Sometimes we interpret that scripture to mean that way. But that's not the intent that God has in mind. So I want to take you deeper into that simple portion three verbs: ask, seek, and a knock. And this is an invitation. It is really an invitation. And Jesus is picturing prayer as a journey. This is a journey. And along this journey, call it a trail. If you love trails, I love trails. So when we go on picnics, I always steal some people to go look for the trails. So I went to South Rivers and I picked the trail. And we went to Brighton Beach and we picked the trail above there. And I, to my discovery, I discovered a part of St. Vincent that I never, ever seen before. Kitchen. Lovely piece of real estate. You young people need to start thinking about, I want a piece of them kind of real estate here in St. Vincent. But that's against the point, no, sir? But I'm talking about prayer as a trail. You're going on a journey. It's a trail. And think of the trail that Jesus gives us, three marks along the trail. Good trails always have marks. These are marks along the trail. And this prayer journey starts with a need, but it ends in a relationship. And I will show you that. And that is so important. So, so important that prayer, it begins with you having a need. Most of us, we pray because there's a need. But the journey should take us to a relationship. Think of your infants. When your baby came into the world, all the baby knew is about my need. They wet and you hear them scream. Them hungry, them scream. And you run, come along. So before the baby develop a relationship with you, the baby was all about needs. You need, I need this wet. Come, take it off. I'm hungry. And if you think you could sleep there tonight, if you think I'm going to allow you to sleep and I'm hungry there, you're making a sad mistake. And their little thing, their voice so high pitch. You understand what I'm saying? You got to get up. So it's about need. But you notice, yes, but you notice, as you respond to the needs of the child, then you develop this fantastic relationship of bonding with the child. Every mother could say amen? Amen. Fathers, you're supposed to say amen too, because you know. I used to pretend I didn't hear. Nice to confess in church, doesn't it? So I am saying to us, behind these three verbs is a greater and a deeper and a hidden meaning that we want to discover this morning. But believe it or not, needs are what will first drive us to our knees. So we say, needs first drive us to our needs, but it's relationship that will keep us there. Believe it. It's as we develop that relationship. So let's take the journey and look at the first mark along the trail. It says, ask. And really, it refers to the requests that bring us to prayer. And most, believe it, most prayers are preceded by needs. When you come back from the doctor and the diagnosis is not good, what do you do? What do you do? You pray. We pray. When you get into a, sometimes we are in some dangerous accidents. We pray. There is a breakup in the family. There is a divorce. There is a serious problem in the family. What do? We ask. We ask. Sorry, my throat tricking me this morning. When we find ourselves in hot water, we ask. Jesus is inviting us. It's an invitation to ask. Ask. Whatever be the need in your life, what do? Ask. Don't feel shy. Because you know, based on our personality, and especially us adults who value independence, we usually shy away when we have a need to ask people. Me no want them to insult me. So we don't ask. You can't say that of God. If there is a need, what do? Ask God. And God wants us to ask him the specific need. Don't say, God, bless me. That's vague. That ain't had no meaning. Bless me what? Say, God, I'm single. I need a good man. I know I will catch you underwater. Amen. That's a wonderful one, man. Amen. God, I love the single life, but I will prefer to have by my side a helpful Christian man full of the Holy Ghost and all of that. Amen. Say amen to that. He invites us to ask. Ask. So you look at your bills. And you look at your money in the bank, and the money can't pay for the bill. What do? There is an invitation to do what? Ask. And God said, keep on asking. So after you pay the bill, and there is another need, what do? Ask. Ask and ask and keep asking. I never get fed up by people. Ask. You see, life has a way of throwing us some low blow. If you are older, you will find that out. If you're too young, you're going to find it out soon. Life throw you some bad blow. Some blow that you have to go down. Some blow you get, you got to go down. Sometimes we're going down and we call murder. You burn your belly and ball. Because sometimes we decent. Why we are not, you understand, tearing out your hair. That's why them fellas in Bible time, when them fellas get real thing, them rip them garment, man, bust their shirt.
think they're mad. It's a way of expressing, man, anguish and need. And when you get to that point, this is the invitation that you get. Ask me, man. Ask me. My resources are endless, man. The banks in heaven could never run out. Ask me, man. Ask. Wonderful invitation. And James said to us in James 4 and 2 and 2b, he says, you do not have because you didn't ask. Now I say, simple. We don't have our needs met because we don't ask. Sometimes we think the asking is too childish, it's stupid. Ask. It's a need. Ask. In the old hymn that says, oh, what peace we often forfeit. Oh, what needless pains we bear. All because we do not tarry everything to God in prayer. Ask him. Sunday to Sunday, ask. From 6 to 6, you ask. Ask. Then there's a journey. So the thing that brings us to prayer is very often the need. And that's why when we get to heaven, there will be no more prayer. You know? There will be worship and praise and all of that. Well, if you call that, that's a part of prayer, fine. But along this journey, he said, seek. And seek. The word seek is all over the scriptures. All over. We are instructed to seek God. Throughout the stories of the kings and the judges, the poetry of the Psalms, the cries of the prophet. There is this cry in the Bible to seek. And Jesus points us along the prayer path. We come asking and we discover relationship amidst our mess. We come seeking gifts, but very often we discover the giver. We discover the one who could give gifts. God himself as the giver. And so the psalm in Psalm 63 and the verse 1, the English Standard Version says, oh, my God, you are my God. Earnestly I seek you. My soul thirsts for you. My flesh faints for you as in a dry and weary land where there is no water. You see the progression. What we are seeing is a progression. We come asking, God, I have a need. Give me this. But like the child, after a while, what do? We develop a relationship. And then we begin to seek God. Continue to seek him. is it strangely enough, our prayers for a number of people only end with the asking. That's where it stops. But Jesus wants us to go along the path, the trail to seeking. For I tell you, if you spend enough time in asking, you're gonna develop this beautiful relationship with this wonderful Savior, this wonderful friend called Jesus. And the thing about it is, you are gonna seek Him even when you don't have a need. Because you're now friends. It's a wonderful friend of yours. And it's the beauty. It's the beauty about now His presence. Just to be with you. I just want to be where you are, says the song. We seek Him. And you could read scripture, and it will tell us a whole lot about seeking God. Remember, we said at the beginning, need brings you to prayer, but it is relationship that will keep you there. So why are we not praying more? It's because we are stuck on the trail. We are stuck on the trail. We are stuck on the trail of asking. That's all that we want. We are about hand. We are about just the hands of God. All we see is the hands of God. Bless me, bless me, bless me, O God. And we fail to go further along the trail of seeking God and seeking a relationship with Him. Keep on seeking. That's what the Bible says. You know, there's a song from the same psalm that I just quote that says, my soul follow hard after God. Early in the morning will I rise up and seek Him. Listen, we are beings always seeking something, you know. We are being with a crazy passion for something. Every one of us are crazy about something. No, your children are crazy about ice cream. I see ice cream. Ice cream. That's why. We are crazy being about many, many things. And we go seeking. Some of us seek other people. We are into relationships. And my God, the passion that we have with our relationships. We're seeking something. All of us have the passion to seek that which we are relating to, that which we are in relationship to. It occupies our time, our attention, and you name what? Seek God. I pass some guys down the road. They can't hear me. I talk soft. we pass a group of guys down the bottom, down there, near to the bridge. And listen, you pass the group of guys there. I don't know if they went to work, they come there. But I come to Bible study and we leave here after 9 o'clock and they're there. You understand the drive? I'm talking about the drive, how people seek things, how they seek out one another. They seek out the things that they enjoy. They have this. We have this drive and this passion. Where is the passion for God? Where is the passion to seek God? Or are we just the type when we are only up when we have a need? Stop mama guying God. Stop disrespecting God. Do you know when you do that? So I know that some of you children, sometimes when you see they look nice to you, you want to say, what you want? How much you want? You understand what I'm saying? Is that they only look to your hands. That's it. All you are is a money. All you are is an ATM machine. The only relationship you have with them is when they have a need. Give me this, give me that, give me that, give me this. My soul, the need and the asking must lead to the second, must go along to seek God. I seek you, God. Because you see, there is something about the presence of God. There is something about just being with God. There is something powerful about the presence of God. You see, when you come out of the presence of God, the God who already knows your need, there is enough power that is released from his presence that takes care of your need, that takes care of your enemy and the distraction and all of that. Seek God. Keep on seeking. Well, we thought those three verbs mean, well, if I could just carry on and carry on, perhaps God. It's a progression. And it takes us along the trail. Jesus said, knock. Knock. And it will be open unto you. And as it were, this is the destination of the prayer journey. Keep on knocking. And it implies intentionality. Persistence. And think of the house along this trail. The journey ends with the house. And we knock at the door because the one who is inside there is the one I need. And I don't want to stand outside the door. I want the one who is behind the door. I want to meet that person face to face. I want to meet with God. And you see, biblically, the biblical image that this conjures is that of you sitting at the table. Behold, I stand at the door and knock. If any man hears my voice, I will come in and sup with him. But you notice with prayer, there is a reverse. He is in the house where he ought to be in that passage. So the knocking the knocking conjures that I want to have communion with the one who is behind the door. I want to have communion with that person. And understand that in Hebrew thinking, to commune, Hebrew people always celebrate communion with food. It was a culture that had plenty food. But most of you not old enough. But you know, we are living in a fast food age. Right? So eating food don't say a whole lot. You're going by a fast food, I ain't saying much. But think of when you invite somebody to a meal, whether at your house or you take them out. The modern thing is you take them out. And Jesus was always practicing this kind of sitting down and eating with others. And sharing a meal in Bible time spoke of acceptance, about dignity, of equality. It was about table fellowship, communion. And it was like a great affirmation of character, and it was the truest and the deepest form of intimacy to sit and to eat with another. And you notice how Jesus was criticized on multiple occasions because he broke bread with tax collectors and sinners. He ate with them. And he seemed to always be at the table with the most notorious people. Prostitutes, sinners, thieves like Zacchaeus them. You see, in Jesus' time, rabbis wouldn't share table with such people. But the greatest illustration of prayer Jesus gave us is the one he lived. The infinite. Think of it. The infinite. The Alpha, the Omega. The holy, infallible one welcomes us to the table. Keep on knocking. Why are you knocking? I come to the person who is behind the door. The person is Jesus. You see, very often we feel unworthy. Unworthy. But Jesus invites us to the table. And he demonstrated it in his lifetime. Was not afraid or ashamed to sit and eat with sinners and publicans and all of that. What a picture of prayer. Prayer really is an invitation to sit at the table, to have full fellowship with God Almighty. That's the destination of our prayer. We come for food, but we find a friend. Isn't that wonderful? We come because I have a need, but along the way, I discover the very giver. The very giver. And prayer in any form by anybody is God's invitation to pull up a chair to the table and enjoy a time with God. That's prayer at the best. Knock. Jesus said, just knock and the door will be opened. Keep on knocking. The door will be open. That's the level of prayer I want to get to. Amen. Amen. I want to reach where I have an intimate conversation with the triune God. For when we read the pages of Scripture, we see how Abraham and David and these guys had this level of intimacy with God. God sharing his secret with Abraham. That ain't change. That ain't change. In fact, those of us who are bought with the blood of Jesus Christ have more privilege than Abraham or David or any of these other guys. We are washed by the blood of Jesus Christ, man. We ought to be able to come knocking and enjoy an intimate moment with the triune God. That's the deep meaning that Jesus has with these three verbs: ask, seek, and knock. I don't know where in the journey you are, but don't get embarrassed if you are at the very beginning, that you have just begun just by asking. It's a beginning. Don't stop there. Don't stop there. Don't stop there. Don't you ever stop there so that you don't pray after God give you your need. What you notice in life is, so let's go back to the prayer now. That God pray, you pray, God give me this wonderful man. And then God give you this wonderful man. But I tell you, the moment you start living with this wonderful man, that wonderful man is a human being. He's not an angel. He's not God himself. And you're going to discover that that wonderful man has some dirty sit down. And you're going to have to come back and ask God, God, give me some wisdom to live with this man. I love him, you know, God. But oh, God. He has something about him, oh God. Amen. You gotta come back. You know, you always would have to come back to him. It is not a one-time thing. You gotta come back. And then, you know, man, then you have children. And oh, as the children come, you have problems. You have to put them under the blood of Jesus Christ. You gotta be praying for them constantly. It's not a one-night thing. Go along the trail. Go along the trail. Ask. And then you got to seek God. You got to seek God. There is no problem. You don't even know what to pray for. But there is something inside of you that is driving you to God. Go to God with your whole heart. We're at different part of the journey, but don't stop. Go to knock. Go to knock. I want to sit at that table. I want to have an intimate conversation with God. That's where God wants to bring every one of us. There is power in this thing, but it can't be. Prayer is not a one-night stand. Have to be. Keep on asking. Keep on seeking. Keep on knocking. There is such power in prayer. Amen. There is such power and authority that is released upon people who will pray. Pray. Amen. Keep on praying. Don't you stop it. Keep on growing in it. And I tell you, the more you get into it, is the more the invitation calls you to come. For this is like any natural relationship. As you live together, and as you get to know each other, and you start valuing and respecting one another, you get so close that, you know, after a while, husband and wife start looking alike. Yes. Start. The children them usually pick that up, you know. The children them say, oh, you know, well, I know that's why I didn't come to you. Oh, you tell me the same thing, I come to you because I know he will tell me the same thing. You start thinking alike along a certain thing, and you will be surprised that husband and wife, they every now and again say, but I was thinking the same thing. The same thing come to me. Because it's out of the intimacy. In psychology, we call it a simulation. That close, people who are close after a while start taking on the characteristic of the person they are close to. You grow together. They flow into each other. And you would understand when you talk about prayer that Jesus is saying, listen, whatever you desire, it means that as you reach to the level, to the destination, you stop praying selfish prayer. You quit praying your own agenda, your own desires, and you start reflecting the desires of the one you have sat with at the table, the one you're in love with and has your full attention. Are you going to go on the journey? I invite you. Jesus invites us to this interesting journey along this prayer journey of ask. Wonderful and beautiful. Let us pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, there is something about your words. Your words are powerful. They are life-giving, life-transforming. And we pray today, God, that your word will reach to the depths of our hearts. And we will be changed. We give you thanks now. In Jesus' name.
I'm reading my B-I-B-L-E, and this is what it says to me. It tells me that I'm never, ever alone. I'm learning how Jesus came down to earth and gave his best. Without a doubt, the best friend you'll ever know. Our God knows exactly what I need. So I remember this. When he acts, he cares. When you seek, he's there. When you knock, 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 God opens up the door. When you ask, he cares. When you seek, he's there. When you knock, 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 God opens up the door. Yeah. I'm reading my Bible, and this is what it says to me. It tells me that I'm never, ever alone. I'm learning how Jesus came down to earth and gave his best. Without a doubt, the best friend you'll ever know. Our God knows exactly what I need. So I remember this. When you ask, he cares. When you seek, he's there. When you knock, 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 God opens up the door. When you ask, he cares. When you seek, he's there. When you knock, 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 God opens up the door. I'm reading my Bible, and this is what it says to me. It tells me that I'm never, ever alone. I'm learning how Jesus came down to earth and gave his best. Without a doubt, the best friend you'll ever know. Our God knows exactly what I need. So I remember this. Let's go. When you ask, he cares. When you seek, he's there. When you knock, 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 God opens up the door. When you ask, he cares. When you seek, he's there. When you knock, 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 God opens up the doors. So when you ask, he cares. When you seek, he's there. When you knock, 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 God opens up the door.
God opens up the door. I want us at this time to pray for Bishop George Frederick. Last week, Monday morning, he suffered a stroke. And he's now a patient at the Milton Cato Memorial Hospital, recovering. And our God is able. When we have a need, we ask. We ask, and we will ask on behalf of Bishop Frederick this morning. Let me ask you to stand as we unite our faith together. God, you are able. God, you are more than able. He's able, he's able. Jesus, we confess today that you are Lord. Lord over all. You are Lord over our bodies, oh God. And we bring today, God, your servant, lying
in that bed at the Milton Cato Memorial Hospital. Oh God, we're praying now for a visitation. Send your spirit now. Send your spirit, oh God, in the same spirit that raised Christ from the dead. God, we pray that it will quicken his body in the name of Jesus Christ. We ask you, God, that you will touch his body now. Oh, Jesus, we pray that the clot in his brain, we pray that it will disappear now in the name of Jesus Christ. And we ask you, Father, that the effects of that stroke, oh God, on his left side, we speak to his brain now. We speak to the brain cells in the name of Jesus. God, we are aware that medically, cells of our brain that have died could never be repaired. But God, you made these cells and you can create them. You can recreate them. You can restore them in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Brain cells, we send a command to you today in the name of Jesus. Every cell that is dead, live. Every cell dead, live. Live. You spoke to those bones in the valley of dry bones. Oh God, you said we must prophesy to those bones. We prophesy now to those brain cells. And we say, brain cells that are dead, come alive. Come alive in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Jesus. And oh God, we pray now. We pray that the connecting nerves of the brain to the left side, we pray that there will be connectivity now. Send power along those nerve ends. Send power, God, in Jesus' name. We say, foot, move in Jesus' name. We say, hand, move in Jesus' name. Hallelujah, hallelujah. We speak to his lungs in Jesus' name. We speak to his, Jesus' gullet in Jesus' name. Let brain movement coordination return now in Jesus' name. We praise you, God. We praise your name, O Lord God. Hallelujah. 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 We praise you, God, for the manifestation now of healing in his body. In Jesus' name. Amen. 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 You may have your seats for a while. Yesterday at the WIST SVG Extension, had a lovely graduation at Faith Temple. And quite a large group graduated with their certificates in practical ministries. Among those was our assistant pastor, Dave Kane, and we want to offer our congratulations. And Sister Alexander from New York. New York. WIST has a large reach. So Sister Brenda, she's here with us. Could you stand, and your two sons,
came down for the graduation. Amen. We'd ask you in a while after our communion to come and greet the folks. But congratulations, and we pray that you will go to the next level. And you won quite some awards. Student of the Year Award. Amen. That's a notable achievement. And may God bless you. All right, we are going to get into our communion at this time. As we remember the Lord, his death, his burial, and his resurrection. And the Apostle Paul admonishes us that we must let every man examine himself, and so let us eat. As we come before the table of the Lord in this celebration, as we remember this supreme gift, this magnificent act of love that our Savior did. So, Father, we still our hearts before you. In a moment of self-examination. But God, you call on us, let every man examine himself or herself for the purpose to eat, to partake. And we pray that the blood of Jesus, God's Son, will cleanse us of all unrighteousness. Every act of rebellion or disobedience or omission, we confess them to you, O God. And you said, you will cleanse us of all unrighteousness. God, your words go further by saying, as far as the east is from the west, will you remove our transgressions. Thank you. Thank you, God. Thank you for your freedom in Christ. God, it is for freedom that we have been freed. To walk in liberty in Christ. And God, you said, we should not be entangled again with the yoke of bondage. Thank you for freedom. In Jesus' name. Amen. All right, we do it as usual. There are two stations. We start these over here, come over. And in the middle, come straight ahead, and then the people on the wing will then come after. So you can come now to the table of the Lord.
I'm reading my Bible, and this is what it says to me. It tells me that I'm never ever alone. I'm learning how Jesus came down to us and gave his best. Without a doubt, the best friend you'll ever know. Our God knows exactly what I need. So I remember this. When you ask, he cares. When you seek, he's there. When you knock, 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 God opens up the door. When you ask, he cares. When you seek, he's there. When you knock, 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 God opens up the door. I'm reading my Bible, and this is what it says to me. It tells me that I'm never, ever alone. wondering how J.S.U.S. came down to earth and gave his best. Without a doubt, the best friend you'll ever know. Our God knows exactly what I need, so I remember this. Let's go. When you ask, he cares. When you seek, he's there. When you knock, 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 God opens up the door. When you ask, he cares. When you seek, he's there. When you knock, 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 God opens up the door. I'm reading my Bible, and this is what it says to me. It tells me that I'm never, ever alone. I'm learning how J.S.U.S. came down to us and gave his best. Without a doubt, the best friend you'll ever know. Our God knows exactly what I need, so I remember this. When you ask, he cares. When you seek, he's there. When you knock, 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 God opens up the door. When you ask, he cares. When you seek, he's there. When you knock, 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 God opens up the door. I'm reading my Bible, and this is what he says to me. It tells me that I'm never, ever alone. I'm learning how J.S.U.S. came down to us and gave his best. Without a doubt, the best friend you'll ever know. Our God knows exactly what I need, so I remember this. When you ask, he cares. When you seek, he's there. When you knock, 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 God opens up the door. When you ask, he cares. When you seek, he's there. When you knock, 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 God opens up the door. I'm reading my Bible, and this is what it says to me. It tells me that I'm never, ever alone. I'm learning how J.S.U.S. came down to us and gave his best. Without a doubt, the best friend you'll ever know. Our God knows exactly what I need, so I remember this. When you ask, he cares. When you seek, he's there. When you knock, 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 God opens up the door. When you ask, he cares. When you seek, he's there. When you knock, 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 God opens up the door. When you ask, he cares. When you seek, he's there. When you knock, 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 God opens up the door. When you ask, he cares. When you seek, he's there. When you knock, 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 God opens up the door. When you ask, he cares. When you seek, he's there. When you knock, 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 God opened up the door. It tells me that I'm never, ever alone. I'm learning how J-E-S-U-S came down to us and gave his best. Without a doubt, the best friend you'll ever know. Our God knows exactly what I need, so I remember this. When you ask, he cares. When you seek, he's there. When you knock, 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 God opens up the door. When you ask, he cares. When you seek, he's there. When you knock, 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 God opens up the door. I'm reading my Bible, and this is what it says to me. It tells me that I'm never, ever alone. I'm learning how J-E-S-U-S came down to us and give his best. Without a doubt, the best friend you'll ever know. Our God knows exactly what I need, so I remember this. When you ask, he cares. When you seek, he's there. When you knock, 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 God opens up the door. When you ask, he cares. When you seek, he's there. When you knock, 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 God opens up the door. When you ask, he cares. When you seek, he's there. When you knock, 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 God opens up the door. When you ask, he cares. When you seek, he's there. When you knock, 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 God opens up the door. When you ask, he cares. When you seek, he's there. When you knock, 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 God opens up the door. When you ask, he's there. When you seek, he's there. When you knock, 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 God opens up the door. When you ask, he cares. When you seek, he's there. When you knock, 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 God opens up the door.
Thank you so much, Ijaz, and the musicians and the whole worship team. Very beautiful today, and other days, and other days. Put your hands together for our entire worship music department. Very wonderful, talented worship leaders, all in their very unique way of leading God's people in worship. Yes, Sister Alexander, you could come, and your sons are growing quickly. Last time I saw, I think was a youth retreat. Quite grown up. Amen.
Thank you, Pastor Bishop Williams.